Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to share with you a product I have found on Amazon and I tested it out and I really, really love it. And so I figured I would share it with you just in case you are looking for something similar like I was. So today I'm talking about the Swedish dishcloths. I've got a very crunchy bag of them here. I don't know if you've ever heard of Swedish dishcloths because I haven't until a couple of weeks ago, but basically what they are is a cloth made out of 70% cellulose and 30% cotton. They are eco-friendly and biodegradable alternatives to a paper towel, simultaneously a paper towel and a sponge. That's why they're called dishcloths. Truly, these are kind of amazing. So I am normally not a person that uses sponges. I am someone who uses paper towels, but I'm not someone who uses sponges. I try to go the more hygienic route, I guess, and I use a brush, like one of those dish brushes. I don't know if you've ever seen them. Maybe you have one yourself, and they're great, but the thing is that they don't always get in all of the nooks and crannies, especially if there's like a corner or like a detail that you want to get at. So I was thinking about how I wanted to describe these because I wanted to come up with something that really truly described them. And I thought of this and I'm kind of proud of myself for doing that. I don't know if I subconsciously saw it somewhere and thought it was my idea or maybe it's my idea. But anyway, I thought a good way to describe them is more absorbent than the paper towel, more versatile than a dish sponge. Okay, so I know that sounds kind of like, you know, a nice saying, but really truly I feel like that is how I would describe these. So I personally use these for cleaning dishes and scrubbing and that kind of a thing. I don't use them in all the ways I would use a paper towel, but I do use these as a replacement for a sponge, and not a replacement but kind of like an upgrade, because they are eco-friendly and they are more versatile. I got the most popular ones on Amazon that had the most reviews and that were also most cost-effective. It says they last for, I think, like 100 times or 100 uses, something like that, but they don't last forever, so I was trying to be more cost-effective. These also are made in Germany, even though they're called Swedish dishcloths. Some are made in Sweden, some are made in Germany. This is kind of a popular concept, so now I think other countries are picking them up and just, you know, promoting them but producing them within their own country. So anyway, these are kind of cool because initially what you get is this. Like, they feel like papery type thing. It does not feel like a sponge. They're kind of hard, but once you wet them, they soften right up and become like a mix between a sponge and a paper towel. They work so well though. I was cleaning a Yeti, and I have a video about how to clean a Yeti because I really needed to clean mine, and I have like a way of doing it that I thought would be helpful, so I made a video about it. And I was using the Swedish dishcloths to do it because actually for the longest time I would use a paper towel and it wouldn't work as well as this did. So this was perfect for cleaning my Yeti. It did an amazing job of picking up stains, and also, funny enough, I thought, oh no, once I start picking up coffee stains and tea stains on the cloth, I was like, oh great, now it's gonna be stained, because of course I got a light color. But no, thankfully the stains came right off, and you know, so that was wonderful. It really looked pretty new and pristine. Once they dry, they do become hard again, but not like shriveled up hard. I've seen comments when I was looking at them initially that people said like, oh, I don't understand this, this is so hard and weird, and I was in my head picturing that it was going to be something really like shriveled up and just unusable. They do become harder and they do kind of keep their shape how they were left to dry, but honestly, as soon as you dampen them, they soften right up, so it's really not an issue, and they work so well. I think they're even better than a sponge. Now obviously there's so many different types of sponges out there, but I just love the fact that you get this surface to work with. It's so much more convenient to clean with this than it is, I think, a sponge in a lot of cases when you're like cleaning dishes and plates and whatnot. I love the fact that you can, obviously this is a dry one, but you can bend it and you can like really get in all the nooks and crannies. I love these. I think these are amazing. I think these are something you can absolutely use alongside a sponge or instead of a sponge, and definitely alongside a brush. And you can use them to clean more than dishes, but personally, I feel like that's where they shine. Whoops, I just totally got some makeup on this one. Whoopsies. Oh, so as far as how to store them, because that's something I was really interested in, because obviously this is a large size, and how do you store them? I've seen people like hang them up like this if they have like a nice place to do that, or even like hang them off of like little, I don't know, dish rack setup situation, which I don't have either of those two options. So what I'm gonna try to do, and as of right now I don't actually have the organizer, the ceramic organizer I got, but I will insert a video or a picture if I get it, and I love the way it holds this. And if you do fold it, I think it probably takes a little bit longer to dry, but it does dry pretty quickly, so I don't find that folding it makes it not dry well. Honestly, if you squeeze it when it has a lot of water in it, a lot of water comes out. It's very absorbent, but also it lets go of a lot of water as well. It's kind of amazing. And I just love the fact that you're using something that's made from natural materials and not plastic, and it's biodegradable. So it's amazing, because these don't last for a while, neither do sponges, but you can use them for, you know, 100 times, which is a lot of times. And after you're done with them, they are biodegradable, and in my experience they don't hold on to stains that easily, because if they don't hold on to like coffee stains, that's a pretty good sign, so they can be kind of kept pristine. I really love the color of these ones here. It's not, they're labeled as white, but they're actually off-white. I don't know if I can show you something in comparison. So like my mug, hopefully it doesn't have, oh great, has lipstick stain on here. That's not really cute. Is there anything white I have that would, oh, here. Okay, I don't know if you can see that. But my little blanket here is like pure white, and this is kind of a natural color. It's a really pretty color, like it's kind of like an aesthetic color, so I love that. It's not a fun color, but it's a color that would kind of blend into the background. These also come in beautiful designs and patterns. There is one that I really love that I will link down below in case you're looking for something kind of peppy to put in your kitchen. It has beautiful lemons on it. It's so, so pretty. It's more expensive per dishcloth, but if you can somehow display them, it's actually really, really cute. And in fact, I have kitchen towels that have lemons on them that I really love, and they do kind of like spruce up the look of the kitchen. So yes, I wanted to share these dishcloths with you. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. I will continue to use them and love them, and I think I will get a pack for my mom because I feel like she's going to love them as well. I just think these are such a great addition to any household and a kitchen, because like I said, they are more absorbent than a paper towel, and they're more versatile than a sponge. They're biodegradable, they last for a while, they clean really well, they dry really well. I just think they're amazing. I feel like they're so worth a try. So anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give this one a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel for more future videos like this one, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye!